Now we begin this journey with Psalm 120. Now, the pilgrim that we are looking at here and his family, we are going to find out where he lives. So let me read Psalm 120. In my distress, I cried unto the Lord, and he heard me. Deliver my soul, O Lord, from lying lips and from a deceitful tongue. What shall be given unto thee, or what shall be done unto thee, thou false tongue? Sharp arrows of the mighty with coals of juniper. Woe is me that I sojourn in Meshech, that I dwell in the tents of Kedar. My soul hath long dwelt with him that hateth peace. I am for peace, but when I speak, they are for war. Now, this is one of the most marvelous psalms that we've seen, and it's relevant to the present hour, and especially for the nation Israel. Now, will you note this, because this is very important to see. Now, this pilgrim lived, he says, in Meshech, in Kedar. Now, who is Meshech? Meshech was one of the sons of Japheth. You find that back in Genesis 10, verse 2. And from Japheth came the Gentile nations. And friends, that's where Israel is today, scattered among the Gentiles throughout the world. They dwell in Meshech. And Kedar, he was a son of Ishmael. Does that tell you anything? He was living among the Arabs. That's rather up to date, is it not? That's where he lived. And it actually was not a very good neighborhood. He really lived in a ghetto because there were a bunch of gossips around there, had mean tongues. Deliver my soul, O Lord, from lying lips, from a deceitful tongue. Not a very good neighborhood. He'd been maligned, lied about. And I do believe that no people have been probably lied about and maligned and persecuted as the Jew has. Now, we are hearing a great deal today about minority groups. Now, the very interesting thing is the Jew's been able to make his way among all nations, among all people. But he's been criticized. Anti-Semitism is something that is quite real. But he's been able to survive all of it. And he's a minority group among the Gentiles and among the peoples of the world today. So he's lived in the place of gossip and of quarrels and of tensions and problems and burdens. And I'm not sure but what that is a picture of you and me. And now the time has come to go to Jerusalem. And it's a time when you pack up your troubles and your old kit bag, and you start toward Jerusalem. He left his burdens at home. And so he left his Meshech, and he left his Kedar, and he now goes to Jerusalem. And he lived in a world of war. He says, my soul hath long dwelt with him that hateth peace. I am for peace, but when I speak, they're for war. That's rather up to date, isn't it? It's a wonder the high critic today, who likes to move everything in the Bible up to date, that is, give it a late dating, it's too bad that he didn't have someone over there today write this, because it's very much up to date, by the way. Now he's going up to Jerusalem to worship, and Jerusalem is a city of peace. Sure isn't today. It's a rather dangerous place to be, by the way, but it was different then, and it's going to be different in